spooked. I'm playing a spooky game. It's spooking me, guys.
What's the game?
Nyctophobia.
I really hate that game.
Really feels shitty.
Yep, it's a 1 out of 10. Turd.
That's not the vagina one, is it?
Also, Pink Monkey's got his shit. Mm-hmm. Seriously, how the fuck do I get out of this tutorial? Like, how do I start the main game? It's not apparent.
Okay. What the fuck just happened? Shitty fucking guide. Dude, their guide is so beyond shitty, I can't even stand it.
Told you.
Killed myself near the end because these fuckers didn't say anything. Remember what you did for that woodsman achievement? Or did you play this a long time ago?
I didn't beat it, their guy was shit. I gave up immediately. It's Pink Monkey's guide.
Why does he make guides like this?
It goes back to his days when he made guides on steam-powered achievement hunters. He's a useless turd who wants to get his name out there. It's the Steam Guide Achievement Writer's equivalent of spray painting your name on you. He's retarded.
Alchemist. found out how you made the toaster explode at least.
You still playing that shit?
I'm experimenting.
What's Rias about now?
don't know if picking up these batteries makes my points lower or higher.
What's up? What did I miss?
Tell me how the fuck to get out of this stupid tutorial screen. Zenik has been stonewalling me.
For what game?
Tom.
Tutorial? I don't even remember a tutorial.
Dude, I mean, there's only a tutorial. That's the only option I have. I beat it in another game.
Here,
let's
screenshot.
Sure, I guess. Straightforward option just to start the campaign. Like, it's just sort of.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there's a hit J, and that'll show you your quest, and that'll tell you where what you need to do.
Just says tutorial done.
Oh, you finished it. Then hit escape.
And?
Main menu, save game, exit, whatever.
I mean, yeah, but then I. That's sort of this. There's no next. I can make a new character if I want.
Exactly, that's what you do. Because this character is just the tutorial character. It's not part of anything. So you do new game, new character, and make sure you set it to the correct difficulty and whether you want to play in the base game or the DLC or.
Have the basis game, but there really is no apparent way to start this. It's just my options are random, look, pre-made, select custom tile, and cancel. Take a look.
Yeah, that seems right. You haven't clicked a race.
Well, just I wanted to show you the screen I'm looking at.
Yeah.
Click
human and then pick human or superior or whatever. You have to, within those races, you have to click a sub race.
Higher or something. Or Hulk, I guess. I see. So I was just retarded and missing something obvious. Thank you for clearing up a very stupid fucking oversight on my part. Boy, I have no fucking clue what I'm doing now. Got all these points and shit. What's a fun build, Hick? You got a guide?
The Bulwark. And basically just bulwark it up. Just get big armor. Yeah, just get armor, get all the stuff. I particularly like the charge ability and the shield smash.
Zenik noted, and I think correctly so, that mirror match type shit later in the game will be nightmarish if I put all my points in now. How can I avoid that?
Basically just fight against things and only put in points when you start getting whomped.
Oh, when I start dying.
Yeah. Basically, if you do get to a point where the enemies are too strong for you, then boost yourself up and then try and see if it's evened out.
Still unsure how that... That's what I mean. I kind of want a build guide.
It really doesn't matter. They don't do too much.
You'll need so many different builds for so many different achievements. That's why it just doesn't really make sense. You'll have to pretty much learn every build.
Yeah, especially since you're just trying to get through the difficulties. Like, there's no point in trying to do it one way on normal. Just hurry up and beat normal so you can go to insane, etc.
That's sort of just it. I'm trying to make an idealized build.
There's no such thing. Like, once you get to your...
For just straight playing the game, I like Archmage a lot, but I don't know how other people feel about it.
You have to unlock Archmage, don't you?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. That's why I'm like, just bulwark it up. You'll unlock classes, and eventually you'll choose one that you like once you're at the highest difficulty.
Do you start with bulwark?
Yes. It's like one of the only things.
It's just, yeah, kind of tanky class, so it's pretty good for beginners.
Yes. And you actually spawn with weapons now. The original spawning from Bulwark had it with no weapons.
Was it just a shield?
Not even that. It was literally just blank because he fucking forgot. But I mean, you'd find something within the first few steps anyway.
Cool achievements.
Oh, the other thing you want to go is to, was it T4E? TE4?
I already did that, like, oh. All, like, logged in and shit.
Okay, good. Yeah. Is that way you can push Steam achievements?
Well, I was planning on just getting the 100% offline and then just like activating them all at once to make masses.
It doesn't work that way.
Yeah. You won't get achievements offline?
Yeah, it disables it.
How often do people claim they get the achievements offline in this game, though? Seriously.
It's like 3 or 4 a month, probably.
But it
hard disables it, and then also it ties it to the save, so whenever you do go online, it goes, hey, we know that this isn't gonna work.
No.
And you know, because like the thing is, like, so if you got disconnected by the server and you notice that it happens, you have to force quit the game so it doesn't save, because if it saves, it locks you out. And you can no longer get achievements on that save, on that character. So you have to start a new character.
Yeah, you always got to make sure you're watching if you're online on Steam or not. And the game will go down for maintenance every day. I think like twice a day.
I haven't had it gone down too much. It's only done it twice to me. But
I think it's every day at like 7:05-ish would always hit me.
Yeah, and you just basically need to watch for that, because it's not just like Steam being offline, it's the internal server for Tome. So if that goes offline, that's when you go, okay, I gotta force quit and not play until it's back up.
That's stupid. What happens if you earn achievements during that time period? Can you break the game? Because there's plenty of situations where that can happen.
No, it doesn't do anything. Again, if you earn achievements while it's not connected to the server, it doesn't track it, and it also hard locks the save, so it gets no more achievements. Like, you'll still trigger in-game achievements, but they won't push to Steam.
Not even if you update from the website?
No.
Nope.
Stupid.
The only thing the website does is for stacking achievements.
Yeah, it's only for the difficulty unlocks.
Did you do this Nyctophobia game, Nikki?
No, I was gonna try it out though.
It's shit. I'm telling you guys, Pink Monkey's guide is useless. Keep trolling, y'all.
I can't tell if he actually made it as a troll guide or not.
No, he's just retarded. I'll confirm that.
He's got an attitude problem.
No, he's an idiot. Like, don't you remember, like, his shit posting on Steam-powered Achievement Hunters, Hickey? Or weren't you around back then?
Which, yeah, he has an attitude problem.
Like, he used to post guides, like, he would post hundreds and hundreds of these useless guides. And he would just say things that were, like, really general and weird and didn't really make any sense.
Yeah.
And I... one that sticks out in my mind was this alien swarm guide he did. It was for fucking the one where you have to blow up 3 boomers, and he's like, I think it was on, like, level 3 or 4, but it could have also been 5. It was level 4, by the way.
One of the achievements in this guide for this game is freaking Nyctophobia game. It's just like that. It's like, I can't remember exactly where it is. I think it's, like, somewhere around here. Good luck.
Turn left and then go up. Yeah, he's retarded, man. But it went on, like, it was just like, and it didn't even list the correct enemy and shit. Like, I don't know, I was really incensed. I wrote something on this guy, like, oh, you're stupid. I thought it was really funny when that site went down in flames.
His friggin' Stardew Valley guide tells you to edit your save files.
Yeah,
he shows
well,
you how to do it.
It's the flames.
Was this the other guy we're talking about?
Pink Monkey's guide, different guide.
Oh, he had a guide. There was someone else who had a guide for Dream, because one of the things is broken, and he's like, oh, I have a fix for it, and he posted the fix, and it's not a fix. It's literally just editing, copy-pasting the file and changing the name, because the way the achievements work in Dream is they have two files for each achievement, and the file is the false and the true for whether you have the achievement. And so you just take the true one and you rename it as the false one. And because in game you have false, it hits that and goes, oh, true.
The fucking
and
battery packs are
like,
points.
That's not a fix for it. It's just fucking, it's Super Meat Boy level of stupidity. And he's like, please don't ban me. And I'm like, I can't allow that.
What happened with that Schrodu thing with him?
Oh, dude.
Samming, resamming, unsamming.
he's weird. He's like, yeah, I just like to test things out, but then like doesn't make anything public or like let us know about stuff until he gets caught. So I'm pretty sure that he's just testing things to see what our auto blocks are, to see what he can get away with. Which, I mean, he's already failed on multiple levels because we just have all this wealth of information and data on him.
He's just such a fucking toxic person on top of it. Like, that dude needs to fuck off.
Who?
It's Schrodu fucker. It's so weird.
I love it. People who've been here for 2 weeks and try to change the entire community.
He's 2 weeks old. Well, that's why I don't know him. He's practically.
He's not 2 weeks old.
He's a couple months now, but he's essentially a 2-weeker.
Why is Guan Yu unbanned? What happened there? Please fill me in.
Who's that?
That guy that made the Kostler picture and fucking like, I don't know, sand bunch of shit. He was just a cheater and then, like, tard raged on the A-Stats forums after he got banned.
I don't know. Show me the, profile
name. I don't even remember why he was banned originally. I don't have access to the mod logs, obviously. But he made, like, a shitty fake 100% achievement group, and I've been telling people, yeah, leave that, like, I cheats. I want to make sure I'm not full.
Oh,
shit.
Yeah, I saw he wasn't banned. I feel kind of bad for that dude. Looks like he has a very sad life.
Like I said, link me the shit. Can't do anything without a link, buddy.
Hold on, I'm getting there. I mean, I remember the Kostler shit. I watched that shit happen. He had that meltdown and said, like, take me off the website. Like, I don't want to be a part of this anymore. He went full tard. I'm trouble finding him now.
God, I'm like on my fifth extra playthrough of this game now, and it should have taken me one. Thanks to you know who.
Oh yeah, enhanced Steam. That's the profile. You got a whole bunch of shit that I'm sure is verifiably false, if nothing else. There he is.
Interesting. Koss unbanned him. Is it the same Guan Yu?
I would presume. Perhaps he unbanned Sam shit.
He did. He undid his clicker heroes. He's still blocked in Lumina.
Good morning.
Still a charm.
Yeah, he must have made appeal, because this was like months ago.
Well, he definitely still has that fake-ass group, and it's still really lame, and people shouldn't join him, that's for sure. Don't you remember what it was, Hick? It was like just a picture of like a pair of ass cheeks. A female pair of ass cheeks, I guess. But just it was
no intense. Idea.
It was a joke for a while there. Stuff happening in Tails, you just kind of walk around and kill monsters.
Yeah, you just did it's straight dungeon to dungeon. You just okay, back to world map, find a new dungeon. You know, there's only so many, they're not really random at all. If you're just doing to get to the difficulty, just do all the main quest stuff, which is like you gotta go to the last town hall, you gotta go find the staff, you gotta go get the thing that'll teleport you to the other side. Then over there you gotta kill all the orc tribes. Rinse, repeat.
Are we devaluing term achievements, are we?
Yep. It's the goal.
Yeah.
Lovely.
No reason for them to be worth as much as they are.
It's not that hard. It's pretty simple. I mean, yeah, I've had 100 hours in it. But it's not been like hard hours. I'm not even doing grind yet. I'm just kind of like, I'll jump in and do like 10 minutes to get 9 achievements. Cause it's just one achievement. Like I know where to go. It's just that simple.
Do you use the ordered pathfind much?
No, it crashes. Like once you're past level 20, it just crashes.
Oh.
But like, probably for normal and like maybe the next difficulty, it probably won't crash until endgame. It's something to do with like once people have enough abilities and auras and like auto on-site kind of spells, then the game like freezes up once it tries to trigger all those.
I see.
So, like, if you just run around normal, it won't hit whatever cap it hits that makes it freeze.
I might have to do some turn after I finish Tiny Bridge Rat Venture.
Alright, well, I'll be okay.
an invisible wall to them. Great. Super useful.
Minutes in the game, and
did Hey, Danky.
Hey, Danky.
Oh, no, crash. That's what you're on about. Bloody hell. Damn.
It's a pretty shite game. I'm very confused as to why people like it.
Like what? Who the fuck likes Tome?
All the autists that gave it overwhelmingly positive reviews on Steam.
You'd love it, Cynic.
I fucking despise that game with my core.
What's up, Danky? Yay! Yeah, I'm building bridges for rats.
Is it true that Danky wrote the song "I'm So Pretty, I Feel Pretty"?
It's possible.
Welcome, Lady Hawk.
Jinx.
Owe me a Coke.
Seriously, I'm trying to find this, like, treasure, and it keeps giving me a Lua error. It's
fucking weird. Isn't that half the fun about playing Tome?
I don't know what the hell it's for.
Tales of Lua errors. Doesn't respond to anything, and a couple of his helper minions only respond to very, very select few genres of things.
Yesterday.
That one didn't count. You're at a LAN party.
Yeah, we all did one yesterday.
Every feature should count.
You didn't even do one yesterday.
I did.
I didn't see it.
I didn't see it either.
I fucking posted it. Don't challenge me.
I saw it.
Well, I'm just saying, I didn't see it.
If I saw it, it counts.
Thank you, Slav. That's all that matters here.
Yeah, we'll get another one done soon.
Daily selfies. Daily danky. Daily dankies.
Ah, the lair of a mighty troll. What the fuck that means? Seriously, this game sucks.
Then what? Play?
No, it's great fun. Dedicate yourself to it for 900 hours now.
More like 200, I think, but yeah, it's gonna take me a month or two. I don't have time to play real games, I have to play Tome.
You should probably trust Venek because he's the master of things.
Yeah, what do you mean by 200?
Yeah, I got a cheese!
Bunch of idle time.
You have to idle.
Yeah.
Because there's dev pushed events that he'll only do like one every other year or something for a few of them. So you have to just leave your game on all the time and hope that it'll push it while you're online and get it locked to your character on the proper difficulty set and everything. And then that becomes the scariest game of all, because if you lose that character, it's so scary.
Oh,
How are you getting on with Nyctophobia?
I think I just beat the base game.
So you just got earned the night to go now. That's pretty easy there, bud.
Wait, did you say you just did own the night mode, Festus?
No. I did Nyctophobia ages ago. But it's pretty easy.
Oh.
Own the night, but just watch out for the just watch out for the ones that like come around the side of the container that you don't see.
Your flashlight doesn't run out of power in this mode.
You got generators you gotta turn on. And that's just the easiest way to kill them. There's three sets of generators with the lights. So yeah, the easiest way is just get one of the generators going, lure them all into there, and kill them that way. Then you can move to the next generator. It'll be on the front panel, on the front of it, or the side, or the back. You can turn them on.
Hi, Dad.
Which generator did you go for? Might be on the side. Yeah, there should be a control panel on it. We need to press F. And don't turn all the lights on, only turn three of the lights on, and then go get the notes. Once you turn the fourth light on, it'll be end.
Mm-hmm. on my flashlight. That's all I want to know.
Too weak.
Thank you.
There you go, Zenik.
Yeah. I fucking died at the end. How? What?
What happened?
I don't even know. Why am I streaming this?
Did you get hit by one of the containers? I'll watch and I'll see what you're doing.
Dude, I don't even fucking know. They're so hard to see. The game's silent now for some reason. What a piece of shit.
Yeah, just keep luring as many as you can to the lights. All the ones that are around that light, there's... How many spawn spots?
Too many. They look like cloakers.
That's, I had never thought of that before.
This game is taking me so much longer than it should. Oh, baby.
How many hours you up to now?
I don't even want to know.
I'll tell you.
Probably nearing two. Or past.
Are you kidding? Yeah, 1.2 currently. Yeah, you should have done that ages ago. Took me 62 minutes. Oh, so it took Danky 2.5 hours. Or 2 hours.
The guide was so bad, I had to play the base game over like fucking 5 times. I can't remember how many lights I've turned on now. When they spawn, it's so sudden and, like, it's fucking weird.
Yeah, I find the... If you go in a clockwise direction from the first one that you turn on, the third one turning on, that's a real bastard. There's one that hangs right near it and you can't get to it unless you lure him away for quite a while and then just sprint back to it and turn it on.
And your flashlight is just the most god-awful thing.
It's just useless in there.
It won't pop that you killed them all until you end the level, huh?
Yeah, I think so. I'll just check when mine.
Bastard game.
Yeah, not all of them, all four of them won't pop until you finish the Own the Night. That's the Note Taker 2, Vanquisher, Bring the Light, and Own the Night.
I don't know why my game's gone silent. That's the weirdest shit of all. I mean, I'm kind of thankful for it because it was super annoying.
Hey, Blitz.
Hey.
Blito.
Who is Blitz?
You were right all along. Expert was easier. Thought you were trolling, but you had the truth inside of you.
Do I ever troll?
Yes.
How dare you?
Alright, I'm gonna hope I killed all these fuckers.
Oh, number one.
Easy game, dude.
You'll need to game do a Tiny Bridge rat feature. It's just like Bridge Constructor, but with rats and cheese.
I'll play that if you play Avoid Sensory Overload. Please inflate this game more.
I don't even have it.
Oh. Boom.
I caught Bionic Jew, though.
You should start that then.
That's the hundo.
Don't do it.
Yeah. Start it. I'm 10 achievements in. Wait, 11 achievements in out of 200 something.
I saw Apollo